afternoon. At this time, we will remain standing for the presentation of our flag and for the Star Spangled Banner, sung by Dr. Joel Knapp, Professor of Music.
The dawn's early light, what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Please be seated. Good afternoon again and welcome. I am Ann Boyle, Interim Provost and Vice Chancellor for Academic Affairs. I am delighted to welcome you to SIUE's 2012 Fall Commencement Ceremony. This afternoon, the university will confer degrees to the graduates of the College of Arts and Sciences, the School of Engineering, and the Graduate School. I am pleased to introduce you to some of the members of the platform party who are with us today to extend their congratulations to our graduates. Other members of the platform party will be introduced during the ceremony. Each person will rise as their name is called. I do ask the audience to hold your applause until all are recognized. Mr. Ken Neer, Vice Chancellor for Administration. Dr. Narbeth Emanuel, Vice Chancellor for Student Affairs. Mr. Patrick Hunley, Vice Chancellor for University Relations. Dr. Girish Gupchup, Dean of the School of Pharmacy. Dr. Regina McBride, Dean of Library and Information Services. Dr. Rhonda Comrie, Faculty Senate President. Mr. Keith Beckerer, Staff Senate President. Mr. Eric Zimmerman, Student Senate President. Please now join me in acknowledging them with your applause. In the front rows before me are seated members of the faculty and staff. It is through the dedicated work of these individuals in designing and executing the curricula of the university that you have been able to achieve your educational goals, culminating in your graduation today. Would the faculty and staff please stand? Thank you. Please be seated. It is now my pleasure to introduce the Chancellor of Southern Illinois University Edwardsville, Dr. Julie First Bovey, who joined the university this past July. As our eighth chancellor, Dr. First Bovey comes to SIUE from the University of Wisconsin-Stout, where she served as provost and vice chancellor for academic and student affairs for the past 7 years. At UW-Stout, Chancellor Bovey provided leadership to their nationally recognized quality improvement program and served as senior examiner for the prestigious Malcolm Baldrige National Quality Award Program, She currently serves as the Higher Education Chair for the American Society for Quality and is providing national leadership to science, technology, engineering, and mathematics initiatives. Chancellor Furst Bovey is nationally and internationally recognized for her expertise in many aspects of higher education and has authored numerous articles and books, including the book titled Quality and Performance in Higher Education. She has served as a quality improvement consultant for numerous colleges and universities and is currently providing consulting services to several international universities. Chancellor Furst Bovey is a member of St. Louis Civic Progress, Innovate St. Louis, the Executive Committee of the Leadership Council Southwestern Illinois, and the Hospital Sisters Health System Quality Committee. She also serves on the boards of directors of the Southern Illinois Collegiate Common Market, University Park at SIUE, and Girl Scouts of Southern Illinois. She has been working tirelessly since she arrived, and Chancellor Furst Bovey is committed to guiding the university toward our future through a university-wide strategic planning process while supporting our current mission to be recognized nationally as a premier metropolitan university for the excellence of our programs and development of professional and community leaders. To quote Southern Illinois University President Dr. Glenn Pichard, and I quote, "Dr. Furst Bovey has the right combination of skills and expertise to continue the momentum that SIUE has built during the past decade," unquote. Ladies and gentlemen, we are extremely honored to have her as part of this institution. Please join me in welcoming to her very first SIUE commencement our new chancellor, Dr. Julie Furst Bovey.
Good afternoon, and welcome to SIUE's Fall 2012 commencement. I'm very pleased to join our faculty, staff, and guests in officially congratulating our graduates on the achievements that have brought them to this point. Graduates, today we celebrate in your honor. You've come from a variety of backgrounds, you have very different experiences, yet you have in common the fact that you've changed our university forever. At the end of today's ceremony, you will share alumni status with more than 90,000 fellow Cougars and will be ready to launch into a new phase of your life. Although we're all proud of your accomplishments, we recognize that you've not reached this point alone, that you've had the support of others. For 4 years, and for some of you for even more years, you've received support from many people, and I'm sure they're very proud of your achievements. These individuals include your family members, parents, guardians, grandparents, spouses, siblings, children. Could all of these family members please stand and be recognized? And to help introduce you to some of our 90,000 alumni, I would also like to recognize those who have previously graduated from SIUE. Will all of the Cougars please rise? Graduates, as I'm sure you realize, you're about to enter an extremely important period in your lives. Earlier this week, I spoke to a group of young professionals in this area, some of whom recently graduated as well. They asked me to discuss the elements that I believe are important to those just starting their professional careers. I'd like to share 3 points with you. First, establish your priorities and your goals. Every one of us has an idea of where we'd like to land, so you must think about how to get there. As Vince Lombardi, former head coach of my favorite football team, said, "The man at the top of the mountain didn't fall there." With foresight and careful planning, the chances of your success on your chosen path are greatly increased. Second, once you enter the professional arena, and some of you may have already done that, it really helps to get involved in your community. And by community, I mean not only that in which you live, but your professional community as well. Select projects, organizations, associations, and causes that you are passionate about, not only to enhance your networking opportunities, but to give back a portion of what you've received from others. Key here is to be selective so you can concentrate your time and effort to maximize your impact. And third, have and later become a mentor. I believe this is essential. As a mentee, you'll benefit from the wisdom and experience of someone who's been where you want to go and likely has successfully weathered the challenges. Later, as a mentor, you will have the opportunity to give back while continuing to grow in your field. It's a win-win situation. What goes without saying is that your values will be paramount in the direction of your lives. As you know, SIUE operates on a foundation of five values: citizenship, integrity, wisdom, openness, and excellence. These values offer a cornerstone for your success, even in the middle of these challenging and uncertain times. Those who maintain their values and their focus, who develop long-term plans, and who fully engage in their community will experience the most success. For our part, SIUE commits to ensuring the value of your degree going forward. As Cougar alums, you have access to many campus resources that will help you throughout your lives. Our Career Development Center offers a number of career resources. Our Alumni Association is a wealth of valuable networking opportunities. They also offer business, cultural, athletic events that you can participate in. We have a wide range of graduate and continuing education programs that will help keep you current in your knowledge and training. Our alumni are important to the SIUE legacy, and we're proud to welcome you to this elite group. We want you to stay connected to the university and connected to each other. Graduates, congratulations on a job well done. Best wishes on your career path, and happy holidays. Thank you.
Thank you, Chancellor. It is now my pleasure to introduce Ms. Bev George, immediate past president of the SIUE Alumni Association and a member of the Foundation Board of Directors. Ms. George earned a bachelor's in English from SIUE in 1975 and a master's of science in secondary education in English from SIUE in 1979. She is here today on behalf of the Alumni Association to present the Great Teacher Award.
The SIUE Alumni Association established the Great Teacher Award in 1970 to recognize SIUE faculty who have demonstrated excellence and innovation in providing an education to those students and whose interaction with those students has brought about a positive and often powerful impact. The 2012 Great Teacher Award was presented to Dr. David Kaplan earlier today. Dr. Kaplan is an associate professor of physics in the College of Arts and Sciences. He earned his bachelor's degree from New York University and his master's and PhD from Cornell University. His research work has involved experimental physics, scintillating fibers and cosmic ray detection in collaboration with a cosmic ray astrophysics group at Washington University in St. Louis. Dr. Kaplan is currently writing a textbook on the physics of waves under agreement with a major international publisher. One of Dr. Kaplan's nominators attributed his career choice to Dr. Kaplan's mentorship. After taking Dr. Kaplan's Physics of Waves course as an undergraduate in 2004, he went on to write about acoustic wave scattering for his undergraduate thesis. That led to a full scholarship in the University of Delaware's Applied Mathematics Graduate Department, where he earned a master's degree with emphasis on mathematical acoustics. These days, he is pursuing, with the help of a scholarship, a second advanced degree at the Institute of Sound and Vibration Research in England. Please join me in welcoming someone who clearly has had a positive impact on his students, our 2012 Great Teacher Award winner, Dr. David Kaplan.
graduates. I'm really happy to be here with you today at Commencement. Thank you for having me here. Also, I'd like to thank the SIUE Alumni Association and also my students from whom I've learned so much for this award. To me, the existence of this award illustrates yet again the high emphasis that SIUE and also its excellent Alumni Association place on teaching. I'm proud to be able to say that the quality level of teaching by colleagues that I've observed here at SIUE is the highest that I have seen at any university. I am proud to have such colleagues here at SIUE. And I'm confident all of you graduates have benefited from them. I like being a part of something good, and I know you do too. Now, I know you want to get out of here. This is commencement, after all. It signals that something is finished, so I should finish. Well, I hope I'm not finished. Actually, I was hoping for another 20 years. No, not 20 years talking to you here. That would put even me to sleep. But there are a few things that I do want to remind you of. Of course, as you know, this is not the finish. At least of learning, it's only the beginning. Let's take a moment, you and I, to take stock. Where are we today? Where are you and I today? You've taken many courses. So did I. What has been gained? Well, certainly we learned lots of facts, and facts are important. For example, it would be hard to work in, say, computer science without knowing what a hard drive is, just as it would be hard to work as a physician without knowing how the human heart works, I mean physically for the moment, just as it would be hard to work as an economist without knowing what a gross national product is. Is, then, learning facts so that you are prepared for your career the most important part of an education? Of course, learning facts and preparing for a career is important. But I think that there are a few things important for learning throughout life that are even more important than learning facts. One, I think, is understanding how we know what we think we know. I think this is one of the main goals of a university education. Let me ask you something. Does the sun go around the earth, or does the earth go around the sun? If you go outside and you look from day to day, boy, it sure looks like the sun circles the earth, doesn't it? But I can see from some of your faces, some of the expressions that you're wearing, some people are nodding. You might be thinking, Dave, why are you asking me such a question? Of course the earth goes around the sun. How do you know this? If this makes you pause in thought, be assured you are not alone in this. Somewhat sadly, I must tell you, relatively few people nowadays, including many very educated people, have any idea how we know this. Here's another example. Science shows us that our Earth is 4.55 billion years old. How do we know that? I'll tell you, it's a lot of fun to understand how we know these things. Another important component of a good education, I think, is the learning of a certain kind of courage. What kind of courage is this? It's not the kind of courage that, say, a bully or a conqueror has. Rather, it's the kind of courage that comes from the realization by learners that even as beginners, they and you can accomplish amazing amazing intellectual things for yourself. And that sometimes an extensive technical background in a subject is not the most important thing. How did the ancient Greeks figure out the diameter of the earth without going through it or without going around the earth? They had less mathematics than today's high school graduate has. What's important is the courage to ask questions and to hazard guesses and hunches. Without guesses and hunches, progress stops. But you know what? Simply hazarding guesses is not enough. You and I, we've all seen people who wildly guess all the time. Key is the ability to evaluate your guesses by thinking critically and for yourself. That, I think, is really one of the main facets of a good education, the combined abilities to hazard informed guesses and to critically evaluate these guesses. And recent studies show us that we as educators are now not succeeding so well in that area. It's now not at all clear that the majority of today's young adults leaving college are leaving with that much gain in their critical thinking ability. You will be the leaders tomorrow. To be a leader in the mid-21st century, it is so very important to be able to evaluate and think critically. I hope that you will continue to learn and develop in this. Otherwise, you can be easily led by those who would want to gull you for the sake of their own goals. That is not what we want in a democracy. And we want to hold on to our precious democracy. It is one of the pinnacles of human civilization. Part of this, and this takes, I think, a bit of experience and continued learning, is coming to realize how strongly all areas of human endeavor are bonded together. Understanding this helps us to understand other people, and in that, we advance our jewel, our human civilization. So we need everywhere and everyone to encourage sympathy, empathy, and also confidence in human thought and the achievement bred by it. This can only come from understanding what and who we are as human beings and how we came to be where we are today. With that understanding and that appreciation, we can advance. These are some of the things I think that teachers at SIUE in all subject areas have tried to teach. I hope that we all will continue all our lives to learn these things. Now, I'm told on the authority of Ecclesiastes, better is the end of a thing than the beginning thereof, and I assume that that also applies here to me. Well, I mean at least to my talking to you now. Oh. There is one more thing I do want to say to you. Go Cougars! Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Kaplan, for your contributions to our university, for sharing your knowledge and passion with your students, and for teaching them to ask questions, hazard guesses and hunches, and to think critically. It is greatly appreciated by all of us. Thank you again. commencement ceremony, one graduate is chosen to speak on behalf of the graduating class. To be selected for this honor, students must not only demonstrate academic success, but they must also exemplify the values of our institution. The graduate chosen for this ceremony is Ms. Elizabeth Kinnearum, who is receiving her Bachelor of Science in Chemistry Education. During her time at SIUE, Elizabeth has been both president and vice president of the National Science Teachers Association. She has also served as co-coordinators of the Cougars Volunteering for Science Service Program, a student-run initiative that teaches undergraduates how to present hands-on science lessons in local area 5th and 6th grade classrooms. And today, she will graduate with honors. Dr. Jessica Krim, one of Elizabeth's professors, describes Elizabeth, and I quote, as an example of someone who demonstrates love and passion for everything educational. She understands that opportunity often comes from hard work, and the level of encouragement she lends to those around her is contagious. Elizabeth is a model student because she knows how to think critically and be self-sufficient. Elizabeth goes above and beyond what is expected of her in any capacity, unquote. Ms. Kinnearum, it is my pleasure to welcome you as the student speaker representing your graduating class.
Go for it.
I'm a little short, so I need to change the podium. Well, hello and good afternoon, everyone. Like she said, I am a chemistry education major, and today my education side is going to come out. I like to share life lessons that I've learned. The life lesson that I would like to share with you all today is one that my mother has taught me over and over again, and one that SIUE has reinforced, which is the importance of honesty. As my mother would say, without honesty, you don't have anything. What she means by that is that you can't build relationships with people, and you can't really get to know anyone without it. So if I'm being completely honest with all of you, I'm completely honored, humbled, and terrified to be standing in front of all of you today. Now, I know this sounds completely bizarre considering the circumstances, and because of the fact that I will be standing in front of a much smaller audience on a daily basis when I finally find that teaching job. But some people combat this fear of public speaking by imagining everyone in the audience in their underwear. I, on the other hand, imagine all of you as one of my students. So thank you and congratulations for making up my largest class ever. As a class today, we are going to start off with some important announcements. All of you sitting out there know how that goes. Teachers tell you what homework is due, when the next test is, and just how they think that class is going. The very first announcement is this. Thank you to everyone on the platform party for this extraordinary opportunity and for all of the hard work, dedication, and time they put into making this university a wonderful place. The second announcement, and perhaps the most important, is congratulations, class of 2012. We finally made it. In a very short time, you will be able to walk across this podium, get your diploma cover, signifying that you are now ready for the real world or the next phase of your career. Now, in my classes, after announcements, we do something a little different. And it's something that I've learned from an SIUE professor here that exemplifies this university's values of integrity and openness. And that is positives of the day. And this past semester, I did this every day with my high school students, and I got some very interesting responses, but they ranged from, I scored the only touchdown at last night's football game, to, I got a good night's sleep last night. Now, posing positives of the day to an audience this loud would, or this large, you're not very loud, you're quiet right now, but to an audience this large would be very difficult. I would have to hear lots and lots of responses. So I went ahead and took the liberty of doing a little homework. And I asked current students, fellow graduates, and alumni what their positives of SIUE are. After compiling this list, I found it very interesting that they fell into one of three categories. These three categories make me even more proud to be a graduate of this university and are points SIUE should be commended on. So get ready for your last class. Positives of SIUE 101 is going to be very easy because because you know the answers. It's only 5 minutes long, and there's not a test at the end. So the third most frequent response is kind of an obvious statement, but it's sometimes nice to stop and appreciate the obvious. Anyone who walks around our campus can attest to the fact that it is beautiful here. It's not every day that you can enter a building and see a deer standing next to it, nor does every university have a very large angry geese population, one of which has its very own Facebook and Twitter account. If the geese are the only unfriendly thing on campus, SIUE must be doing something right, because the second category is the fact that we have a very friendly atmosphere. Many commented on the fact that even though there is a large enrollment, there is always a sense of comfortability and camaraderie that you would normally only find at a smaller institution. SIUE provides so many opportunities for students to become involved in something that they are passionate about. Think back to all that you have been involved in, a club, a sport, an organization. I hope that you have been able to find your niche here in SIUE, like I have been so fortunate enough to have done, because it's here that I've experienced that tight-knit community that has led to excellent networking opportunities, friendships that I cherish, and memories that will keep me laughing 20 years down the road. Now, for the number one positive of SIUE and the greatest compliment for an institution of higher learning, it is the education that we receive from the professors. Professors, at this time, I would encourage you to literally give yourselves a pat on the back because you are the number one positive. We have been able to learn an extraordinary amount from you, not only because you are wise human beings, but because you are able to share your wisdom effectively and you genuinely care about us. Students said things to me like, professors are more like family. They are very in tune with our needs and they help us on our quest for lifelong learning. Thank you for helping us explore our academic interests and all the while understanding and caring about our lives beyond the classroom walls. Here comes the moment you all have been waiting for, the wrap-up of the last class and that cheesetastic, inspirational, and motivational message that comes with any great life event. Every speech associated with a major milestone needs that moment, because it's in that moment that the world is right, and I don't know about you, but I feel as if I could do anything right now. Those are the moments that we need to hang on to when life gets rough, and the ones that we need to remember when things are going well. Maybe you can't relate to any of the three positives, but I urge you to come up with your very own list. Whether you like it or not, or you want to admit it to yourself, SIUE has taught you something. SIUE itself is a culmination of experiences and people forcing us to grow in one way or another, in hopes of preparing us for our future lives. This institution has provided us with ample opportunities to get involved in the community, and it's during those times that we are able to work on our communication and people skills. But let's face it, it's the people that were here that truly made the experience amazing. SIUE is where we've met our maid of honors, best mans, future nursing home roommates, and the friends who will have to Skype on a weekly basis in order to maintain sanity. I hope, fellow graduates, that you have been able to learn as much from SIUE as I have. And don't keep all those lessons to yourself. Occasionally, these speeches end with something along the lines of, I can't wait to see what this class can do next. We are the future engineers of the world, curers of cancer, and the artists who will change our current perspective. I'm not discounting this, because I am so excited to see what our class can do. But I want to end with a different message. In life, the big moments are wonderful, yes, but the little moments of every day are what really add up. Leave here with the goal to find one positive of each day. Smile at a stranger in hopes of making their day better. Thank those that have supported you and loved you throughout life in the hard times and the good ones. And last but not least, follow the advice that one of my recent fortune cookies gave. Never forget that your happiness depends on your outlook on life. With that, class of 2012, congratulations once again, and good luck with all of the lessons life is about ready to bring you next. Thank you.
Thank you, Elizabeth, for your honest message and for your contributions to our beautiful, friendly, university filled with great and caring faculty. I think the students in your chemistry classes will be very lucky to have you as their teacher. Next, the candidates for graduation will be presented by their deans for conferral of their degrees. Dr. Jerry Weinberg, Associate Provost for Research and Dean of the Graduate School, will begin by presenting candidates for the conferral of graduate degrees.
Will the candidates receiving graduate degrees, Masters of Fine Arts, Masters of Public Administration, Masters of Science, Masters of Music, and Post-Baccalaureate Certificate, please rise? Chancellor Fürst Bovee, these candidates, subject to completion of all requirements established by the university and the graduate school, are recommended to you for the formal conferring of their respective degrees.
Upon the recommendation of the faculty and the dean of the graduate school, and by virtue of the authority vested in me by the Southern Illinois University Board of Trustees, I confer upon each of you the graduate degree or certificate earned with all rights, privileges, and responsibilities associated with the degree.
Graduates, please be seated.
Dr. Hassan Savim will now present candidates for conferral of baccalaureate degrees from the School of Engineering.
Will the candidates for baccalaureate degrees from the School of Engineering please rise? Chancellor Fürst Bovee, these candidates, subject to the completion of all requirements established by the university and the School of Engineering, are recommended to you for formal conferring of their degrees.
Upon the recommendation of the faculty and the dean of the School of Engineering, and by virtue of the authority vested in me by the Southern Illinois University Board of Trustees, I confer on each of you the baccalaureate degree earned with all rights, privileges, and responsibilities associated with the degree.
Graduates, please be seated.
Dr. Aldemaro Romero will now present candidates for conferral of baccalaureate degrees from the College of Arts and Sciences.
Will the candidates for baccalaureate degrees from the College of Arts and Sciences please rise? Chancellor Fürst Bovee, these candidates, subject to the completion of all requirements established by the university and the College of Arts and Sciences, are recommended to you for formal conferring of their degrees.
Upon the recommendation of the faculty and the dean of the College of Arts and Sciences, and by virtue of the authority vested in me by the Southern Illinois University Board of Trustees, I confer on each of you the baccalaureate degree earned with all rights, privileges, and responsibilities associated with the degree.
Graduates, please be seated.
Now, will all of the graduates please rise? In recognition of the degree bestowed upon you, you may now move your tassels from your right to your left. Congratulations. Please be seated.
Note that the recipients of baccalaureate degrees who have graduated with honors, cum laude, highest honors, magna cum laude, and highest honors, summa cum laude, are noted in the program by 1, 2, and 3 asterisks, respectively. They are also wearing cords on their academic regalia indicating their honors. In addition, candidates who are honor scholars are indicated in the program with a capital H, and graduates who will be commissioned as second lieutenants in the U.S. Army are also listed in your program. The university community extends to each of you our heartiest congratulations on your achievements. We have now come to that part of the program when candidates for degrees will proceed to the platform in program order. The names of the graduates will be read by Dr. Chris Gordon, Associate Dean of the School of Engineering. I would ask that the audience please remain seated during this part of the ceremony. Thank you.
Sarah Beth Borgstedt. Rachel Pease. Okay. From the Master of Music. Miles Adam Vandeveer. From the Master of Public Administration. John Michael Powell. Ricardo Israel Garcia Cervantes. Gregory Crook. Jeffrey Martin Dondeville. Erin Christina Fusan. Jason Michael Greaves. Lynn R. Hilsman. Stephen Edward Lynn. Benjamin M. Moto. Don Michelle Richardson. Heath Ray Weaver. Aram Joshua Williams. Brittany Elaine Williams. For Master of Science, Cynthia Amuako. Rachel E. Carr. Tiwatoyo Fadero. William Frank Feldman. Denise Nicole Green. Susanna Oweredua Hanking. Brittany A. Hergich. Elijah M. Muzumichi. Shelby Joe Price. Jeremy William Roundcount. Timothy Lee Tripp. Kelsey Elizabeth Viano. Christine Nicole Ballin. Luke Edward Weber. Jesse Wayne Wyatt. Oluwatosin Faith Fatih Alshunabare. Joseph Angelo Carpenter. Nilufar Eastman. Nicholas Robert Harold. Dante James Orlando Harris. Joseph Thomas Hager. Tengfei Li. Jennifer L. Melton. Mohammed Mubashir. Wang Qing. Rakeshin Ratod. Partha Sardi Samedvedam. Omeza Kolomalo Olomoya. From the School of Engineering, Bachelor of Arts, Brian Douglas McLeod. Bachelor of Science, Brett Bielman, cum laude. Kent James Blunt. Cole Wade Bozarth. Michael James Canole. Michael D. Carlson. Seth Castell. Luke E. Chamberlain. Daniel J. Curtis, cum laude. David Mead Dixon. Sam McDonough. Alex John Dunker. Ryan L. Durham. Maria Rose Dust. Judson Lee Fraley. Timothy Stephen Friedrich, cum laude. Brandon Mitchell Fuller, cum laude. Mitchell William Green. Edward Joseph Grubb, Jr. Philip Lloyd Hardware, Jr. Travis David Herman. James Edward Holt. Andrew Thomas Johnson. James Alexander Kaiser. James Michael Keller. Andrew Joseph Kellerman. Blake William Kreutzberg. Todd Wesley Law. Bethany Marie Lubers. Brent Michael Lyons. Blake R. Meehan. Spencer Tallickson Minert, Thomas Christopher Miller, Brittany Rian Murphy, Ashley Nicole Oseguera, Kevin Wayne Pizolt, John Thaddeus Pajani, Justin Troy Quattrochi, Aaron William Wrench, Robbie Keith Robertson, cum laude, Daniel Brett Roll, John Thomas Samuels, Robert Lowell Sanson, Valerie Catherine Schwing, Alex Michael Schauber, Michelle Schudica, Caitlin Marie Sodom, cum laude, Kyle Allen Starks, Cameron John Stein, Amy Elizabeth Sunderland, Daniel Jeffrey Swigget, Matthew Aaron Tobias, Anthony W. Uzo, Jeffrey Caleb Vance, Calvin Vaughn Wagoner, Spencer Michael Wallace, from the College of Arts and Sciences in the Bachelor of Arts, Casey Gail Andros, cum laude, Ashley Angeli, Brittany Nicole Ahrens, cum laude, Jillian Taylor Babb, magnum cum laude, Michelle Beard, Michael T. Borner, Meredith M. Boyd, summa cum laude, Ryan A. Buck, magna cum laude, Jessica Lee Charlton, Rebecca Emily Coakley, Ryan John Dilworth, cum laude, Daniel Oren Heck, cum laude, Kirk Edward Doolin, Sarah Beth Fan, Dylan C. Ford, cum laude, Jeffrey Wayne Forsyth, Jr., Sarah Ashley Goines, Kayla Ann Hayes, magna cum laude, Andrea Renee Heckler, summa cum laude, Ryan James Herker, Kelsey Jordan Holt, magna cum laude, Michael Austin Houghton, Ryan Matthew Jones, summa cum laude, Hope A. Jordan, Christopher Michael Cleet, summa cum laude, Ashley Nicole Cole Miller. Arturo Lopez. Alicia Sherelle Mann. Thomas McConnell. Morgan Ashley McDaniel, cum laude. Amanda K. Miller. Scott Mitchell. Amanda Jean Noel, cum laude. Justin O. Okozi. Candice Janelle Pike. Matthew Allen Reince. Justy Morgan Roth. Andrew William Schifelker. Robin Ray Shine, cum laude. Molly J. Shelton. Lena Ann Cologne Stuck. Brooke Ann Tolley. Caitlin Trombetta, summa cum laude. Sharina Latrice Turnage. Natalie Nicole Walsh. Elizabeth Frances Knierum, cum laude. Paige Suzanne Marie Walters. Jacob Anthony Sylvester Watkins. Emily Morgan Watson. Hannah Elizabeth Weiss. Brian Lee Wheeler. Hannah Christine White, magna cum laude. Nia Louise Williams. Erica Kane Wolf. Benjamin Wolf, cum laude. From the Bachelor of Fine Arts, Zachary Michael Belusic. Kaylin Elizabeth Marie Hayden. Nicole Renee Lance, cum laude. Michelle E. Lighthizer. Chris M. D. Spangler, magna cum laude. Justin Charles Ulrich. With a Bachelor of Music, Ryan Eugene Coleman. Colin Francis Galvin, magna cum laude. Casey Dean Kelleher. Timothy Martin Moore. With the Bachelor of Science, Andrew Michael Abbott. Margot Catherine Afforty. David Peter Aguilar. Monica E. Allen. Robert Seth Allison. Tara Nicole Athmer, magna cum laude. Carson Lee Bailey. Caitlin Christine Baker, cum laude. Jordan B. Barnes. Jacqueline Marie Barrett. Esther Ruth Beard. Matthew R. Beebe. Melissa M. Better. Daniel Joseph Blaze. Gabriel A. Bowden, cum laude. Samantha Ann Braswell, magna cum laude. Tyler Lucas Bruner. Anthony Lamar Bryant. Ambrosia Lee Ann Butcher. Eliberto Castillo. Brittany M. Chandler. Alicia W. Chung. Kayla M. Clark. John Michael Lee Coles. Kara Marie Colliott, summa cum laude. Rebecca Nicole Corbett. Raquel L. Cox. Amanda Christine Crow. Donald R. Crumley. Sean Joseph Curry, summa cum laude. Nigel Julian Paul DeLuca. Christopher Linnell Densmore. Caitlin Grace Dentamaro. Angela Renee Donzi. Andrew Wayne Dressel. Olivia Elizabeth Ebers. Ashley Shea Elliott. Mitchell Patrick Elting, summa cum laude. Ashley Michelle Ennis. Carrie Renee Foster. Tiffany Ruth Frisbee, cum laude. Morgan Renee Gartke. Brian Dalton Gass. Stefan H. Gazda. Christina E. Guillaume. Matthew Mark Gluck. Adam Michael Gonzalez. Heather Lynn Gustafson. Wanwasin Halimariam. Amber R. Harper. Delbert John Henderson III. Zachary Michael Hewitt. Danielle Marie Hobing. Sarah Michelle Hovis. Dante Ramon Howard. Sloan Ray Hogart. Ashleya Jacole Ingram. Camille Renee Jackson. Gregory Allen Jackson, Jr. Alexander Lee Johnson. Delissa Suzanne Jones. Jasmine Janae Jones. Vincia Kiamari Jones. Kate Ashley Carner. Kelsey Renee King. Corey Bergera Clover, summa cum laude. Andrew S. Lau. Jordan Lockup. Nash Madhu Madokwe. David A. Mader. Michael T. Malone. Lori Lynn Marsh. Alexis Laura McGehee. Melissa Ann McIntyre. Jordan Charles McKinney. James Edward McClendon. Sarah Christine Meyer. Thomas Patrick Menges. Aaron James Mayrick. Taylor Whitley Mole. William J. Morris. Cody Gerard Morrison. Naomi Shadrach Mzengi. Jeffrey Allen Mudd. Chelsea Alexa Nish. Rebecca Lynn Norris, summa cum laude. Ashley K. Obafemi. Nicole Jessica Parker. Jasmine C. Price. Brett Allen Raps. Brian Thomas Reed. Michael Douglas Reimer. Ryan Lee Renke. Megan Marie Rigdon. Hopton O'Neill Rowe. Catherine Rosemary Ruiz. Mercedes Schuler, cum laude. Erin Elizabeth Schwarzkopf. Joseph Preston Scoggins. Zachary Tyler Scott. Matthew J. Senior. Jansen Wade Shaw. Trisha Lynn Seekman. Michael T. Soriano. Emily Brooke Standard. Samantha Joe Stokes. Morgan Christine Taylor. Natalie Mary Taylor. Nicholas Chase Thompson. Jack M. Twelman. Yema Clara Ombe. Aaron Michael Walford, cum laude. Elena Felice Walters. Tyler Miles Wendt. Kelsey Marie Westbrook. Emily Elizabeth Wetter, cum laude. Ashley Marie Witten. Corey A. Wickware. Kelsey May Wofford. Candace Marie Turner.
Let's give our graduates one final round of applause. Thank you. I think they know that you love them. On behalf of the university, I extend our thanks and appreciation to our vocalist, Dr. Joel Knapp, for his fine musical presentations today. Thank you also to the Army ROTC for the presentation of Colors, for making the commencement program available to those who are deaf or hearing impaired. Thank you to our interpreters, Ms. Susan Macbeth and Ms. Brittany McKay. At this time, I ask that you join us in singing both verses of the SIUE alma mater, Hail SIUE, led by Dr. Joel Knapp. The lyrics are printed on the back cover of your program. Following the alma mater, I ask guests to remain at your seats until the platform party, faculty, staff, and graduates have left the seating areas. Please accept my best wishes to each of you and congratulations on your graduation. We hope you will return to visit your university home often, and happy holidays.
Mississippi plain, your splendor meets the sky. You give to all a chance to gain, you raise our spirits high. Hail, all hail, SIUE, our gratitude we owe, our fount of opportunity, where'er in life we go. To college friends we bid adieu and wend our separate ways. Yet college friends and mentors too are with us all our days. Hail, all hail, SIUE, our alma mater true. Let's fill our glasses joyfully raise a toast